I'm too sexy for Milan, too sexy for Chicago, New York, and Japan. Hey, welcome, fans, to another super sexy Sunday edition of the Blazing Beard Bulls blog. That's right, SSSSBBBB. And hey, you know, it gives us something to do. It's perfect on a Sunday, seeing as some asshat can't learn how to throw it out of bounds. Basically, there is no more football for me. So, a Sunday edition, this will be absolutely perfect. And like the Bears, the Bulls continue to decide that they don't want to play at home with people cheering for them. Well, anyway, it looks like it's pretty much the same such bullshit that's going on with the Bulls, that's going on with the Bears. They're not performing at home. And, you know, there's not a lot to say about the game last night except for it was a bad game. It was a bad game all the way around. Poorly played, no D. Leads to no O, no O, no D, no D, O, O, D. Oh my God. OMG. Anyway, look, the Bulls just played horrible, but they've got this classic thing now that they're doing. And this is the perfect opportunity that was missed for Tibbs to play his bench. Right? We've got a problem this year, and that problem is playing like the first quarter and the first half slow, like we don't even care to win, and then picking it up and coming from behind by 15 and coming behind by 10 and coming from behind by 7 and coming from behind by 18 to try and win these games. You are making it tougher on yourself. This game was the perfect opportunity to play the bench, so I am giving you Tibbs a bench slap. It's a lot like a bench slap, but it's even worse. Play your bench. That's the key to this year. You know it, and you had the game. We're 2 minutes into this game with Powell not putting his arm up and the rest of the starters, except for Jimmy, who had a great night, but that doesn't really matter, does it? You should have switched out the starters immediately within the first 2 minutes, put in the bench, and played them as much as you possibly could so that you can get something out of them. Because if you're going to go on this West Coast trip, and if you're going to try and have an entire season, and you've been okay so far, I was giving you a B+ for substitutions, now you're getting a C-, and the bench is looking like it. Okay, so this has got to change. This is the perfect scenario for the bench to play, so please, play the bench, play the bench, play the bench. Otherwise, bench slap for Tibbs, bench slap for Chicago, especially when they don't come out with the right kind of energy. Now, like the Bears, when you have this much money and you're not putting any fucking effort into it, it makes fans pissed off, right? I mean, you know, if you're going to come out there and not even really fully try, you might as well put the Blazing Beard in, because the Blazing Beard has got defensive moves. The Blazing Beard doesn't take any shit. The Blazing Beard stands over people like Pippen stood over that freak in New York, and I don't even know Ewing. Well, I don't have to know his name. I'm a Bulls fan. Anyway, folks, look, Jimmy cannot be bent over like he's so exhausted that he's playing the Jordan flu game. You've got to get these guys rest. You got to do it smart. You can find the Blazing Beard Bulls blog on, what's that thing, Facebook. Oh yeah, Bulls Connect. So check it out. Find me on YouTube. And I need subscribers. I need, oh, the Holy Spirit on a Sunday to come down and subscribe. So please post it for your friends if you like what's going on here, if you think it's too sexy. And look, just like Jimmy Butler and just like B-Fett and G. Grimlock, I remember B-Fett saying, he's no good to me dead. Tibbs, you can't overplay the players this season, or they're not going to be any good to us in the playoffs. Blazing Beard, much too sexy, yo. Whoop.